Good day, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Briareus Kerensky and welcome to the unboxing of the limited edition of Galgan Returns. As the logos here and here should have tipped you off, this is the Japanese Nintendo Switch edition, and let's get right into it. So, on the front cover there is this badge that tells us that this is the 10th anniversary of the Galgan series, alongside the logo of the developers, IntiCreates, and the 0D rating on the bottom left corner. The sides of this box just have the logo of the game and pretty much nothing on top and bottom. While on the back, again, a group shot of the six main heroines and four screenshots detailing what this remake is all about, and this indicates that pretty much all of the DLC from the X360 version are included. And below everything else we have the contents that of course include the game, an artbook and the soundtrack. Below that, the technical details. Well, this is a game you play alone and you need two hands to play it. Anyway, let's get a look inside. Now, everything is packed really tightly. Memorial Artbook, Nintendo Switch game, and as I did the first hour play before this unboxing, yeah, it's unwrapped because I've already played the game, and the soundtrack. And this is the game that on the front cover has only five of the main heroines, again the badge and the logo of pretty much everything, spine nothing out of the ordinary, and on the back, well, pretty much what we've seen on the other box. And no manual, no inner cover, just the Switch cartridge. This is a pretty plain game case, so I want to make up for this with this, the X360 version, the original version, and as a quick comparison, the covers are pretty much the same, only with updated art. So, on the back, well, four different screenshots, a couple of technical details, the spine is the typical spine of X360 games, and inside there is the disc and the manual, and I forgot about this, there is this telephone card. Yes, this game is pretty old. And this postcard for a questionnaire. We didn't have a Switch manual, but now we have an X360 manual. So it's about controls, the interface, and what you have to do. And the various mini games. And this is the MOM mode. On the Switch you can press minus to enter this 8-bit rendition of the game. It has been a staple of the series, well, ever since the original, which I guess this is. This soundtrack is not really a soundtrack, but a song collection that on the front cover has four silhouettes of the main heroines. Galgan Returns song collection title, logos we've already seen, spine, well, this is completely out of focus. Let's show it later. And the six tracks, which are the vocal songs found in the game. They are the opening and the various endings. A rather colorful disc with the credits in English. Okay. And let's show the spine. I can't really show it, yeah. By the way, it only says what this disc is. And a very flimsy booklet, which is just two pages, with the lyrics of the songs. And finally we get to the Memorial artbook, which is quite an hefty artbook. It is not bound, it is just glued, but judging from the size alone, both in terms of page size and page number, this is going to be a good artbook. I really hope. By the way, front cover, we have the four angels, three angels and one devil featured in the whole series, and on the back, just the logo of the remake. And so that's the jacket. Let's remove it to see what's inside. Heroines of the first game, and nothing much on the back. So being this a memorial art book, and judging from the front cover, this is gonna cover all of the games, including Galgan VR, which is the only one I haven't played. Nice prototypes. DLC Swimsuit, which is included in the base game, in the base returns game. And I can see that the art was more, let's say, chibi at the start. Pretty glad they changed this. Of course, this is the art of the 2011 version. The Returns version will have its own section at the end. Ooh, there was a policewoman character. These Yonkomas are included in the gallery of Galgan Returns. Unfortunately, the Switch version I have is not translated, which, a lot of things that haven't been translated in the game are still in Japanese, unfortunately. I will detail that in the review. Evil Ekoro. Or maybe this is a prototype for a completely different character before Ekoro became Ekoro. This is a DLC present, not in this version, but in this final version. These are the pre-order bonuses when the original Galgan came out. In double piece. One thing I discovered replaying Returns is that a few, not that many, generic characters, quote-unquote generic characters, aren't present in Returns, like her or this teacher, and these two teachers. Illustration gallery. Storyboards. I never bought any of the DLC costumes. I like this one. So pre-order bonuses or slash retailer bonuses. Galgan VR and immediately to Galgan 2. You know that a character is popular when she returns in multiple games. I'm looking at you, Kurona and Aoi. And to be right, and to be honest, they have all the rights to be popular. Again, I never bought any of the DLCs for Galgan 2, but I'm pretty happy about this thing if it ever made it to the definitive game. Also the slime, nice. And these are the art from Returns. And this is the games gallery. And that's it for the art book. Well, it is a disappointment, I'd say. Before closing this video, I want to show you a couple of bonuses. One, this bookmark is a pre-order bonus, while this acrylic plate is a retailer bonus. In this case, this is from AmiAmi. There is nothing much to say about the bookmark, it's a bookmark, while the acrylic plate uses the same stand system as other limited editions. For example, I can point out to you Azure Striker Gunvolt using the same type of stand. This limited edition is a mix of high and lows. The lows are the pretty much bare-bone game case and the song collection featuring only 6 tracks, where it should have been the complete soundtrack. The high, of course, is the art book, and for me it completely makes up for the lows. I will say, if you have the chance and like the Galgan franchise, get this limited edition. The first hour play of this game is already available, and pretty soon there will be also a review on this channel, so stay tuned for it. In the meantime, you can go back and see my previous unboxings of Galgan games as well as their reviews. I hope you've enjoyed this unboxing and you'll stick around for more. Briarios Kerensky, over and out.